Well, happening now, the spring fighting season beginning with a brutal attack today in Kabul in Afghanistan. An Afghan soldier opening fire on his own fellow soldiers inside the country's defense ministry. This is just initial reports. We have an unknown number of casualties. The gunman apparently was killed, and the Taliban claimed responsibility for that. In the meantime, new doubts about the accounts from a famous author who advocates building schools and empowering women as a way to win in Afghanistan. Happening now has been very focused on this part of the story and how women fare under Taliban rule. What's next as we begin our troop drawdown in July? Our guest is with us. Gayle Tzemach Lemmon has a unique insight into what's going on inside Afghanistan. She's the author of The Dressmaker of Karkana, a new book that's out now. And Gayle, you were last in Afghanistan in December, we understand it. And we do talk about what it takes to win in Afghanistan. Why do women matter when we talk about that?
Well, I think as we show in The Dressmaker of Karkana, it's because women are contributors. They really make the difference, and they are really allies in the fight to create more stable, more secure communities. They are not collateral damage. They are contributors when it comes to what happens next in the future of Afghanistan and to creating a safer, more secure country, which is in the world's best interest, really.
You know, we're seeing some images on our screen of women head to toe in burqas. Some of the images coming from Afghanistan we've seen that are so salient, the one with the woman with her nose cut off. This brutality of the Taliban. That's the picture we see. You say that there's a different picture, though, we should be focused on. How are they contributing?
Well, I mean, the story of The Dressmaker of Karkana is about young women who became entrepreneurs during the Taliban, who really made the difference between survival and starvation during years in which the whole rest of the world had forgotten them. And I think it's about, you know, are women able to contribute to their communities and to make life better because they are fighting for the next generation to have a better future, which really is what the international community wants as well. And the young women in The Dressmaker of Karkana were entrepreneurs and breadwinners during years in which absolutely no one even remembered that Afghanistan existed. And now that the world's attention is on Afghanistan, we should be investing in these women because they really do make the difference for the future.
And what do you mean by investing? Because obviously some of the women that you profiled did it without, you know, foreign aid.
Right, absolutely. And I think all entrepreneurs really know how to go it alone, but the question is, should they have to? Because these are young women who want a better future for Afghanistan. They want the same things that the international community wants, which is security, prosperity, stability. And I think when you talk about investing, it's a question of making sure women have a seat at the table in determining whatever it is that comes next for Afghanistan. I think so often people forget women, and they're an afterthought rather than being central to the story about their country's future, which they are.
Just a quick final question. I noticed on the cover of your book here that you have a blurb from Greg Mortensen. He's the author, of course, of Three Cups of Tea. And there's been those reports that have just come out that Greg Mortensen has denied about whether or not his storytelling about the plight of women in Afghanistan, his suggestions to the military, is accurate. You're an author. You've obviously had some interaction with him. What's your take on that story?
Well, I mean, I was surprised as anybody by the allegations, but I think what is central, and I think what anybody would say is central, is that it's about girls' education, and it's about who is contributing to their society. And these young women, you see them on the ground every day in Afghanistan, braving acid attacks, braving kidnappings, braving bombings to go to school. And they really are about the future of the country. And if we care about the future with our young men and women fighting there, we have to. These are the people you want to invest in, girls.
It's such an interesting point. As we continue to ask the question, 10 years in, why we're there and what we really want to achieve. Gayle, it's nice to have your insights. Congratulations on the book. And we understand in December, you were 7 months pregnant in Afghanistan, right?
I was.
Congratulations on being a new mom at this point. Already a world traveler, that little baby.
Yes, he's ready to fly anytime.
It's great to have you. Thank you so much. We appreciate it very much.